Hello students, so today we'll be talking about life process chapter. Chapter number 6, life process. So in this chapter we'll be talking about seven kind of life processes. We'll be discussing briefly about them, and especially four which are nutrition, respiration, excretion, and transportation. So we'll be today discussing majorly about nutrition. So basically, why do we need these life processes? We need these life processes in order to maintain our system, and we live properly, all the organs are functioning properly. And when the organs function properly, then only these life processes help us to live in a better condition. So nutrition is basically about obtaining energy by taking some kind of nutrient, some kind of food item which will give us energy, and which will provide us energy to carry out different kind of life processes. So nutrition is one of the very important life process for human being. So when we start with nutrition, we need to understand the definition of it. So if we say nutrition, nutrition stands for the process by which organism takes food and utilizes it. A simple definition of nutrition is the process by which an organism takes up the food and utilizes it. So nutrition we get from nutrients, and what all nutrients are there? Carbohydrate, fats, major nutrients, then protein, then vitamin and mineral, just to get an idea. So these are the ones which are major ones we need a lot, and these are the ones which are we need them in less quantity. So now what are types of nutrition? We talk about nutrition, then there are different kinds of nutrition. So nutrition can be broadly divided into autotrophic and heterotrophic. Right? So autotrophic means, auto means self, and trophic means taking in food or taking nutrition. So now autotrophic means a mode of nutrition in which the organism makes its own food. So makes its own food. For example, plants. And heterotrophic are organisms which are dependent on other for food. For example, simple example, animals. Right? Now when we talk about autotrophic in detail, so we talk about plants. So how do they majorly, the autotrophic ones are plants. And how do they make food? Now, autotrophic mode of nutrition if we talk about plants, then they have special pigments which help in making the food. If they don't have that organelle or those pigments, then they cannot make food. So So they have chloroplasts, in which there is chlorophyll pigment, which actually helps it to do a process known as photosynthesis. That is making up food by the utilization of light. So synthesizing food with the help of light. Now, where is this chloroplast located? If you will read in your NCRT, it is located in the leaf, right? Now, one special thing about photosynthesis is that when they're making food, they also need some raw material. So those raw material are inorganic ones. I hope you can see. So inorganic like CO2, H2O, and these inorganic material, when they combine it in the presence of sunlight, that's how the name comes, photo, and with the help of chlorophyll pigment, they make up glucose. So I'll show you the equation of it to make you understand better. So plants basically do photosynthesis. Which takes place with the help of chlorophyll pigments. So basically there are three major steps of photosynthesis. One is capturing or harvesting. Harvesting what? Harvesting what? Light, photo, photons. Then conversion of what? Chemical energy light energy into chemical energy. And last is reduction. Reduction of what? Reduction of CO2 into C6, H12O6, or simply glucose. So see, these are the three major events of photosynthesis, right? So all these three events takes place. So the equation is 6CO2 plus 6H2O gives you C6H12O6 plus 6O2 plus 6H2O, right? So now here you can see in this particular equation, where are we getting these raw materials from? Now the question comes, we are getting CO2, which is a gas, we are getting it from air, right? H2O, we get it from roots, that is coming from soil, right? So in the presence of light and chlorophyll pigment. Now what chlorophyll pigment is doing? Chlorophyll pigment is capturing or harvesting that light and giving it for the reaction. So that energy, now then chemical reactions take place where these light energy turns into chemical energy, and finally this particular raw material gets converted into glucose with the release of oxygen, and byproduct is H2O, right? So this is the equation of autotrophic nutrition. So for heterotrophic nutrition, we'll see next video. Okay, thank you.